A very safe and good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 31st March, on the front page you have India still in local transmission. So this is what the government says. Health Ministry says implementation of early lockdown is proving to be a step in the right direction. So government has again said that India continues to be in the local transmission phase, despite the country registering a spike from 100 to 1000 cases in 12 days. So the Health Ministry says that more cases have been reported, but it is still in the local transmission phase, that no orders have been passed to conduct large-scale disinfection of people, but protocol has been put in place to sanitize large public places. So community transmission in the sense that from one person it spreads to a huge number of people. And local transmission means from one person to local, in that the few people who came in contact have been affected. So government continues to state that no community transmission is taking place in the country. It is local transmission. And this picture here, you can see how India is among the 41 countries which crossed 1000 COVID cases marks on Sunday. As such, but rise has been relatively slower in India, but even testing has been very slow and very limited in the country. So if you test, you come to no COVID cases, but testing, ICMR has stated, will not take place for any and every case. It will be taking place in severe cases of symptoms, like breathlessness is one of the severe symptoms of coronavirus. 176 countries in the world have registered at least one coronavirus case, and out of these 176, 103 countries have registered at least 100 cases, and of them 41 countries have registered at least 1000 cases, and India is one among them. Out of these 41 nations, only three have huge number of cases. Like they reached the mark of 1000 in very quickly. Like in Japan, in 29 days 1000 mark was reached, in Iceland in 17 days, in Greece in 15 days. And you can see India, and only Philippines and Finland registered 1000 mark in 14 days, which was the quickest, which is same as in India. So COVID-19 test rate has been among the slowest in the world, as I stated. And here the cabinet secretary has denied the center has plans to extend the 3-week lockdown, which is scheduled to end on April 14. So it is said that lockdown would be till April 14. There is no plan of extension so far. And here you have this news regarding migrant workers being given mass disinfectant bath in Bareilly. So healthcare workers here are spraying disinfectants on migrants. These migrant workers were stranded waiting for buses. And such inhuman action has now resulted in action being ordered against officials. Those exposed to chemicals will be examined for any adverse effects too. And below you have Rabi harvest to be affected for want of farm workers. So farmers also worry about government procurement and the ability to sell crops because markets are still closed. So how the economy has been affected by COVID-19, how agriculture has been affected is mentioned here. On the editorial page, you have short end of the stick. So this is regarding migrant workers who simply cannot fend for themselves, how they need urgent state assistance now. So it has been nearly a week now since the lockdown and due to coronavirus, and it is a public health challenge, but also a humanitarian crisis is unfolding as India's huge migrant population is trying to travel from cities back to their home places. Especially in Delhi, it is seen they started even on foot to go to their hometowns in Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar and elsewhere. So they need to be taken care of. Even today's front page news shows how they were mass disinfected by spraying chemicals, because in lockdown is to avoid transmission and community transmission of COVID-19, and the way migrant workers are thronging bus stops, railways have been stopped, otherwise railway stations were also thronged. So that is detrimental to the society, but then their plight also has to be understood. They are suffering. They cannot stay on their meager savings in the cities. They cannot afford food there, cannot afford shelter there as such too. They can't pay such rents. So that has been highlighted here. How government needs to take steps. They should use it. The editorial says schools and college hostels for the migrants to stay on. Also utilize public distribution system to provide food. Then here the second editorial is unusually inept. So this is regarding the US, how it can pull itself out of the virus crisis, but not without tougher steps. So US President Donald Trump has been apprehensive. He says that such lockdowns would result in huge loss to the economy, and that loss will be detrimental to him winning the presidential elections, re-election as such. He expects to be re-elected as president when elections are due in December 2020. So he doesn't want the economy to slow down to such an extent that his electability is affected. So severe steps need to be taken in USA too, is highlighted in this editorial. Then the lead article is Stopping the Spread, Caring for Lives. So this article talks of Karnataka government's approach to fighting the COVID-19 pandemic. So how it is on war footing. And this is the article written by the newly appointed Chief Minister of Karnataka, B.S. Yediyurappa. And this is The Hunt for a Cure Begins with Telling the Truth. So this article talks about how India must uphold the principle of truth and responsibility as such, and speaking up the truth about how much the virus has spread, and allowing for tests to be conducted, and so keeping truth hidden is not going to help in tackling this crisis, is what this article says. Actually, you can skip both these articles. And here on the op-ed page, you have locking down two different Indias. So this again regarding the plight of migrant workers. You can see while some can practice social distancing, most Indians simply cannot, as they have no social security. And this is regarding testing for COVID-19 in India. So how testing has been very slow. So it needs to develop the capability of mass-produced kits for testing to take place and COVID-19 being detected early on to save lives. And this article talks of threat to food security. So keeping global food chains alive is crucial amid COVID-19 crisis. The way we saw agriculture sector suffering on the front page, if such a scenario arises, then it will be a food crisis as such, which everyone has to deal with. Then international page has the same news on COVID-19 in various countries. In USA, emergency coronavirus restrictions have been extended until 30th April now, the way we have restrictions till 14th April. And this is again regarding how Wuhan was able to tackle the virus crisis by testing and mass quarantines. So it's the same news. Okay. And on business page you have SEBI relaxes debt default norms. Raters can go easy. So now after government introduced some relaxations, RBI relaxations and assistance came forth, SEBI has also temporarily relaxed the norms related to debt default on account of the ongoing COVID-19 lockdown and the moratorium permitted by RBI. So RBI has also permitted moratorium. So on the same line, SEBI has also relaxed debt default norms. You can see it said that if a default takes place solely due to lockdown or the moratorium, then credit rating agencies need not recognize it as a default. So a default in any company, by any company, then credit rating agency is downgraded, which affects their performance at the stock market. So it's regarding that. And this is NRIs can now invest in specified government bonds. So RBI has introduced a separate channel named Fully Accessible Route, FAR, to enable non-residents to invest in specified government bonds with effect from 1st April. So the Union Budget had announced that certain specified categories of government bonds would be opened fully for NRIs. without any non-resident investors, without any restrictions. So this has been implemented now by RBI. And below you have cost of lockdown is pegged at about $120 billion. So it says complete stop would put over 45 million migrant daily wage earners out of work, and government needs to do more to rescue industries and services if they want to protect jobs. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.